Good morning, students. Though certain topics were not included in the term one portion, still it's an obligation on my part to teach you, and you shouldn't be deprived of those chapters. So I'll be teaching you the rest of the portion. You can continue your studies of term one. You can see these lectures later when you finish up with your term one. So we had supplementary reader, fourth chapter, the COP and the anthem to be done. COP is the police over here. Now we have, this is a story about a man who doesn't have that much of money. He is actually looking for a place to live in that cold wintry weather. Now, does he succeed in getting a place where he wants to go? Is what the story is question about. Let's see what happens in the story. Have you ever found yourself in a situation in which what happened was the opposite of what you expected? So when, like, truly, like, there are so many incidences in our life where whatever we think doesn't happen and the opposite of it happens. If so, you're familiar with the irony of the situation. Irony is the sad part of it, which is often embarrassing. It actually brings embarrassment to you. The story that you're going to read has a number of such situations. Now, his urge of finding a shelter for himself throughout the story, he makes so many failed attempts, and what actually fetches him the result is the opposite of it. Let's see what is he trying to do and why, and does he succeed at the end or not. Soapy is a homeless, jobless man. Winter is fast approaching and Soapy must have a place to stay. Soapy comes to a decision at last. So winter is a very, this thing over there, cold over there, the place where he lives. And there's snow all around. So you cannot dream of living on roads during winter. So he wants a home for himself but doesn't have money. He's a jobless person, he's a poor man. So how does he manage and what does he do? Let's see. Soapy moved restlessly on his seat in Madison Square. That's the place we're talking about. There are certain signs to show that winter is coming. Birds begin to fly south. So the birds have started migrating. People want new warm coats. So when you can see in the market that people have started buying warm clothes, then you know that the winter is approaching. And Soapy moves restlessly on his seat in the park. When you see these signs, you know that the winter is near. He's sitting in a park right now. A dead leaf fell at Soapy's feet. That was a special sign for him that winter was coming. It was time for all who lived in Madison Square to prepare. So, trees shed away their leaves when it is winter. Soapy's mind now realized that fact. The time had come. He had to find some way to take care of himself during the cold weather. And therefore, he moved restlessly on his seat. So, he knew that he had to do something very fast because the winter was approaching. So he was very restless that he should find a solution to his problem. Soapy's hopes for the winter were not very high. So he did not dream of having a mansion which has got the heater system on and then warm clothes and the cozy bed. This was not his aim. He was not thinking of sailing away on a ship. He didn't even want to move away from there. He was not thinking of southern skies or the Bay of Naples. These are places where warm, you would find warmth. But he knew that he had to do something and it had to be here. 3 months in prison, on Blackwell's Island was what he wanted. So his idea of finding a shelter for himself to spend the winter was to get imprisoned for 3 months and wear on the Blackwell's Island. In the jail, you would be protected from the cold weather conditions also, and then food also would be given by the jail authorities. So that was his idea of escaping the winter. 3 months of food every day and a bed every night. So 3 months he would be having a bed to sleep on and 3 months he would be having food to eat. 3 months safe from the cold north wind and safe from cops. This is what Soapy wanted most in the world. So if he would be in the jail, he would be protected from the cops also, because he's already in the jail. What would the cops do to him? For years, Blackwell's Island had been his winter home. Richer New Yorkers made their plans to go to Florida or to the shore of the Mediterranean Sea each winter. So we're talking about the place, New York. So he says those who had lots of money would make plans to go. They have winter vacation, right? So they would plan to go to Florida. Some would plan to go to the Mediterranean Sea and visit places here and there. But he had nothing but an option that he could spend his winter on the Blackwell's Island. Soapy made his small plans for going to the island. And now the time had come. 3 big newspapers, some under his coat and some over his legs, and had not kept him warm during the night in the park. Now what happens is when you have minimal, like you don't have anything to protect yourself from cold, what people do is when you see them lying on the road also, in Jabalpur also when you are moving around in winter, you see those people who are lying on the sidewalks, they take newspaper or they take plastic and actually stuff it inside their clothes. So that acts as an insulation. This is called insulation, which keeps you warm. So what he had also was something like that. Only he had 3 big newspapers under his coat, he had stuffed them, and some over his legs also. But that was not actually protecting him from the cold, because it had turned very, very cold. So Soapy was thinking of the island. There were places in the city where he could go and ask for food and a bed. These would be given to him. He could move from one building to another and he would be taken care of through the winter, but he liked Blackwell's Island better. Now, it's not, America is not like India. India, the people live on streets also, nobody cares for them. But they have shelter homes. Americans have got shelter homes for the poor and needy. You could move into a shelter home for a night and then you'll have a bed and then you'll have food to eat. But he didn't like that kind of an accommodation. He liked the jail more. Soapy's spirit was proud. If he went to any of these places, there were certain things he had to do. So why, what was the reason that he did not like these shelter homes and he preferred going to jail when compared to the shelter homes? Because when he would go over there, he would have to do certain things which he did not like to do. And what were those? In one way or another, he would have to pay for what they gave him. When you go to a jail, you don't have to pay anything, because that's actually a punishment for you. When you go to a jail, so you don't have to pay for your punishment. But when you would go to a shelter home, you would have to pay back in some kind or the other way. They would not ask him for money, but they would make him wash his whole body. They would make him answer questions. They would want to know everything about his life. So what was the glitch he thought was a glitch? Was the problem was that they would make him bathe. He didn't want to bathe. So they would make him bathe, they would ask him personal questions. This is what was bothering him, and he did not want to go to the shelter home. No, prison was better than that. The prison had rules that he would have to follow, but in prison, a gentleman's own life was still his own life. So his private details, he wouldn't be giving to anybody when it would be a prison. And if he would go to a shelter home, he would definitely will have to say about his life to them, because those questions were obligatory to be answered. Soapy, having decided to go to the island, at once began to move towards his desire. Now, how to go to a jail is the question. Was it so easy to go to a jail? You would not do anything and people would catch you and put you in prison? No. So that means he had to do something wrong. he had to break the law somewhere so that the police would catch him and put him in the prison. So now starts his attempt of doing something wrong which defies the law, and then he would be caught by the police and put in the jail. So the next part of the story has got those attempts, whether he succeeds or not, let's see. It has got those attempts where he tries his level best to be caught by the police and to be imprisoned. The rest of the chapter we'll do in the next lecture. Thank you, dear.